Hello lovely people, welcome to the Geek Cupboard. I am Penge and welcome to Longhaus, which is a game that's part settlement builder, part real-time strategy and part tower defence, where we play as, I think, a Viking, because we start with a Longhaus, and that's sort of a Viking-y type of building, isn't it? But we're also on a floating island in a vast sea of clouds, so we're playing as Sky Vikings, possibly. I'm not entirely sure, but Sky Vikings sound amazing, so yes, we'll go with that. Absolutely, we are playing as some mighty Sky Vikings, and yeah, we're going to be building a settlement, growing food, gathering resources and deploying our troops in order to defend against waves of attackers who do not like our amazing Sky Vikingers and want to kill us a bit. It looks really good. It looks amazing. It's got very sort of slick menus and UI and everything looks very lovely and detailed. And also amazingly, it's free. This whole game is entirely free over on itch.io, so of course there is a link to the itch page in the video description below. If you want to go and check it out and have a go yourself, then you can do so. But I think let's get on with it, shall we? Let's begin the story of the Sky Vikings. So there's four levels in the game. I've done level one. It was more of a sort of tutorial thing. It wasn't overly difficult, but I now sort of know how the game works. So let us dive in to world number two. So here we go. This is world number two. And yeah, look, you can see the clouds. So we are on a magical sort of floating island, but it looks really pretty. So let's go and find our longhouse. So there we go. This is what we need to keep safe. This is the center of everything. This is where all the Sky Vikings hang out. So we need to keep this safe. And that's the target for the enemy. So the enemy kind of rock up in sort of flying longboat type things, which are amazing. And they land over here somewhere and they make their way over to here. That's what they want to destroy. Of course, we want to defend it a little bit. So we've got ourselves all sorts of production buildings down here, and then we have defense buildings as well. Now we do need to get a bit of a shift on because the baddies are still coming in. They're still out there somewhere, out in the clouds, who knows where. So let's get some stuff constructed. So we've got ourselves trees, we've got fields, and then we've got rocks over here. So we can put things down like farms. And you can see up here, we've got food, we've got wood, and we've got metal, and we have a number of villagers as well. So we've got five villagers right now, and those villagers are currently just sort of sitting about doing nothing. So let's get some farms in. Now, when we put a farm down, it works all the adjacent tiles, and the more tiles it works, the more food we get. However, it doesn't look like there's a good place where we can actually get a farm that looks is adjacent to four fields. It can only do three. Okay, that's fine. We'll put a farm just there. Lovely. And at the moment, the game is determined that three people will work on this farm. So that means that our food has gone up, which is very, very nice. And we can also buy some more people. So it costs us at the moment 100 food to get some more villagers. So let's get some more villagers in. Let's get as many as we can. There we go. So we've now got six villagers sitting around doing not very much. So let's get ourselves a lumber mill. And they work in very much the same way. So we put the lumber mill down and then it will work the adjacent kind of forest tiles. So let's put that just there. So now we're getting ourselves wood totaling up as well. And then we want to get some metal as well. So let's get a mine. And again, we don't have a great spot for a mine. We haven't got a spot which can get all four adjacent tiles, but that one will do. That'll do just fine. So there we go. Right, we need some more people. We need some more people. So let's grab some more people. The only thing is we're not producing enough. Well, we are producing enough, but we're not producing loads and loads of food to get more villagers in. We want to make sure that we've got plenty of food surplus. So another farm is going to be quite useful. Let's pop that farm just there. And that's now grabbing lots and lots of lovely food from those fields. However, we have no more villagers. And also, we have no defense. We've got absolutely no defense at all right now. So let's see if we can get... How many more villagers can we get? Another one there. And then 160 for another one. And then 170 for another one. Okay, so all these things are now being worked. The farm has got three people on it. And this farm has got three people on it. And the lumber mill has got three people. And the mine has got three people. However, invaders are now incoming. So we are going to need to get some more villagers. We also need some more defense. Now, fortunately, things sort of pop into existence immediately. They do have two paths in as well. So where are the baddies coming in from? Right, they're going to be attacking from this side. So we want to defend the top over here. So let's get ourselves a lovely tower just there. And then we have, can we buy an extra villager? I think we can. So then we can say to this ballista just here, let's put three people in there. Lovely. Right. Can we get another? We can't get another person in right now. We can put a barracks in. We'll put a barracks in just there. But here we go. So the people are running in, but the ballista is firing quick enough that it's actually able to sort of fight off the first wave of baddies. Hooray! And this thing here, this has people in. So we load the barracks up with three villagers and they turn themselves into soldiers and then they can fight within this radius here. And that's kind of the basic principles of the game, really. makes sure you've got enough food. The food generates the villagers, but also, yes, the villagers eat the food. So you need to make sure that you're generating enough of it to keep everybody fed. We've kind of reached a wood limit. We can get ourselves storages. Yeah, so a granary can store food. And the lumber pile, that can store wood. We'll just pop that there. And then we can get ourselves a metal storage. That stores the metal stuff. That might have to go just there. So now we can store more of each thing. Okay, wonderful. I think we might need another farm. What if we put a farm? There's no wonderful spots for a farm. That'll do for now. We'll put a farm just there, just to get us some more stuff. Right, more invaders are on their way. Right, let's get some more people. Let's see if we can grab some more people. Right, where are they coming in from? Ah, bother. They're coming in from down this side. Okay, so go back to defence. Grab ourselves another tower. I quite like them being on those corners there. That seems to work quite well. Right, this tower here, nobody. This tower here, three people in that tower. However, they've brought with them a big dude with an amazing hat. Wow, look at the hat. I mean, okay, he might come and kill us a bit, but that's an amazing hat. I'm jealous of the hat. And we'll put a barracks down here as well. In fact, let's tuck that right in there. Okay, so the three sort of little sort of dudes are very dead. That's fine. The ballista looks like it's doing all right, though. I mean, this guy's just... Oh, I was going to say he's kind of ignoring this, but... Ooh, right, okay. He gave us a bit of a hit. I think we're fine. I think we're okay. Okay, right, we need... we're going to cap out on our food, actually. So how about we train another villager, and another villager, and another villager. Oh, we've completed an objective. Okay, right, yeah, so we have a number of objectives. I think that first one was have 20 villagers, I think. Let's get another villager in as well. And now... We can have a couple of people in that barracks down here to defend that side. And then we'll put one person in there and one person in the barracks for now. Right. More raiders incoming. We can get some more people in. Okay, so get another villager. Now, where are they coming in from? Where are the baddies coming from? Over here. I mean, this thing here, this is brilliant. A kind of wonderful flying longboat thing. It looks tremendous. Look at that, and they just sail away again. It's brilliant. Okay, so we've got some dudes with axes, and a guy with... what's that? What's that he's got? Oh, is it like a bomb? Oh, yeah, we might want to stop that guy. Oh, right, yeah, okay, right. He's explodey. Okay, can we repair our buildings? R is mass repair. That's probably a good idea. I don't think anything else was damaged apart from that, but okay, well, there we go. Everything else is now repaired, which is wonderful. So we've maxed out on metal. We've maxed out on wood, so we've not maxed out on food quite yet, which means we can get another person and another person as well. Okay, now we can go and reinforce up here a little bit. So another one there and another person in that barracks. Okay, this is all good. Now, yeah, when you place a building down, it kind of just, it sort of, the game works out what number of people you would like in that particular building. So sometimes when we place a building down, you'll see a dot. So a little dot underneath means that's been determined by the game. So it thinks that we should have three in there. But we can just override that. But yeah, I'm all on board for having three in there right now. That's fine, game. That's all okay. Right, where are the next baddies coming from? Over there. I assume they're going to come down this way then. Okay. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. We can work with that. Right, let's get another villager in. So now I've got two spare. So we'll have ourselves another person in the barracks there. Then how about we get ourselves another one of these. Another ballista tower. Let's put that there. And we'll pop one person into there as well. So more defence going down on the south, but there's been more attacks over here to our sort of southern border. And there we go. We just pick these guys off. Boom. Another one. Out come our guards. And they stabbity stabbity. And we'll chop at that guy. Okay. Is it a good idea to engage the guy with the bomb in kind of, you know, close quarters combat? I would probably say no. I would say maybe stay away from the guy with the bomb. But yeah, what do I know? Okay. What's our next goal? Have 1,500 of each resource. Okay, we're going to need more storages for that then, aren't we? So we're going to need another lumber pile, which I don't think they don't need to be near the source of the resource. You know, like the granaries can go anywhere. The only thing is, we've used up all of our space on this little sort of inside island bit. So we are going to need to start spreading around here, which obviously puts our buildings at risk of the invaders. Where are the invaders coming in from? They're coming in down here again. It's two big chaps. However, one of them hasn't got a fancy hat. So I'm not so worried about that, to be honest. Right, let's get a couple more people in. So we've got two extra villagers. That can go up to three. Okay. So this thing should be able to fire at these guys. when they get into range, and hopefully they will then run out as well. And if they come up to this, this ballista here can also fire at them. So they should be okay. I mean, yeah, this one's taking some pretty good damage right now. He might make it up to us. But out come these unfortunate souls who've got to take on these giant guys. Oh dear, our people have just been kind of mercilessly chopped apart. However, okay, right, so we've defeated them. Did we lose some people? I think we might have lost some people. Okay, right, we'll train another villager. And yeah, let's get ourselves another metal storage. Put that down here. Doesn't overly matter. Let's get ourselves another farm and put it on that corner there. And then we'll have three people working in that farm. We haven't got three people. We haven't got enough to train any more villagers. Okay, never mind. And let's get ourselves a lumber pile and then a granary as well. So all down here, where are the next baddies coming in from? Ah, multiple locations. Okay, the baddies are getting a bit smart. So that's going to be on the ground. What are you guys? Who are you? And that looks fun. I do like the look of that. Just, you know, poodling along. Ah, have they got some sort of explosive barrel type device in there? And are they going to drop it on our heads? That would not be ideal. Right, can we get any more people in? Because I've just realised that our northern sort of area is relatively... it's relatively undefended. Yeah. Let's get you in. Hang on a minute. Defence. Get a ballista tower. Pop that there. Tell this ballista tower to have no one in it. And that one can have three people in it. It will have taken a bit of damage. And is anyone coming out of these barracks? That thing is being hacked apart quite readily indeed. Okay, there's only one person choppity-choppitying at that now. Hang on. Come out of there. Put three people into the barracks. Why? There we go. Right, I was going to say, why is nobody going out to hack at this guy? Okay, more invaders incoming. We need some more people. Okay, get to 360. What are these guys doing? Right. I sort of forgot about the floaty guys and their kind of explosive things that they were constantly throwing on us. Okay. So it's not just a case of defending on the ground. We have to defend from the skies as well. Right. I thought they might have come in and had one hit. But no, they were constantly sort of bombing that thing. Okay, so we'd need more of these towers scattered around the place in order to defend from this aerial threat. Okay, right, well, there we go. We'll restart that. Let's sort of get back to where we were. Let's just sort of build up again. I'm sure it'll all be fine. Is it the same level? No. I don't think it is the same level. It looks marginally different. It looks like there's a lot more fields around and less everything else. But okay, right, so get the basics in. We can't do too much with the trees. And then the mine can go... Ah, nice. The mine can do really well. That's very, very good. And we might well need another farm as well, just to sort of maximise things. Okay, right. Well, let's try and get back to where we were then. Let's try and get back to our 20 villagers. And then, yeah, maybe we will put some more defence around the longhouse rather than leaving it sort of very tragically undefended. Lesson learned. Okay, I'm not entirely sure we're back where we left off. I don't know how many invasions we survived before. I can't remember. But we have got two lots of the flying people coming in. I don't think anybody else is coming in. We have not got a land attack, I don't think. It's purely these guys. So hopefully they'll be able to... Hang on, that one's not going to be much use. But that might be useful. And then we've got at least one person that can go in there. And we are getting quite a lot of food. So we can have another person going into that one. It looks like... they're both going to come in range of this ballista just here. So how about let's drop the people in that one and maximise the people in that one. Oh, there's three. There's three ships coming in. Okay, this might require some more drastic measures. Hang on. Pop that there. Take everybody out of that one. Put three people into that one. Okay, right. We're picking them off. We're picking them off quite nicely. Another shot on that one. Boom. Okay. Right, so three lots of them came in. I kind of just saw the two up here, didn't see the other one coming in over here. Okay, right, there we go. Now, yeah, it's quite tricky. This level seems to have less room on it, less sort of immediate space nearby. We have to kind of go really quite far away to actually get some space. Right, hang on a minute. Can we get some extra people in? I think we can get two more people. So we should be able to get two more people into there, which is quite nice. Got a barrack. So we need one, two, three. We need four more people to fully man all this over here to the north. So if we can get another person, that would be nice. So there we go. So the more people you put in the ballistas, the quicker they fire. they're firing at that rate per second. If we have less people, they fire slightly slower. Right, how are we doing over here? Right, that thing is coming in, but we should be able to handle that. So how about we take a person out of there and a person out of there, freeze up two people, put somebody back in there, put somebody in that barracks there, and then, oh no, don't take them out. No, put two people in there. That's what I meant. And they've got one more person that could go up there. No, like that. There we go. And then we can get some more people as well. Yep, get another villager. Very welcome. And I think that thing has been destroyed. I think it's gone. Yeah, all the flying things seem to have been kind of blown out of the sky, which is lovely. Right, more invaders incoming. So we need to get 1,500 of each resource. So I imagine we're supposed to sort of hurry along with this as well. So at the moment, we've got 1,000 tops of each. So we need to make sure that we've got loads more storage. But this is where the problem is. We haven't really got the room to put these things. So we can do that. That means we can store a lot more metal. That's absolutely fine. But then, yeah, we're lacking room to store the granary, to, you know, place a granary. We have to put it there, but then it's kind of at risk of being attacked. So let's put the granary just there. And then a lumber pile. Let's pop a lumber pile just there. So we should slowly see these things filling up. Now, food is going to be the problem to fill up, because we obviously want to get food. We want to acquire food to spend it on training people up, because obviously that's good for our defense. Oh no, there's a guy with a bomb. Shoot the guy with the bomb. Shoot him. There we go. Splendid. Okay. Good job, everyone. Good job. Okay. And a bit of rain coming in. Right. No flying people. No people in their amazing aeronautical machines. Okay. Wonderful. So it looks clear right now. That's really nice. It's really nice, the snow effect. And then, yeah, the game looks great. Whilst there's a bit of downtime, it looks wonderful. All the little people come out and this guy here is chopping away at the tree and they're doing some farming. And the mining guys are sort of hacking at things with a kind of pickaxe. It's all very lovely to look at. It's wonderful. Oh, hang on, what's that? Two possible land attacks coming in from the same side. Well, that's just cheating, isn't it? Right, hang on a minute. Let's get that. We'll equip that with an extra person. Okay, are we going to be a right up here? Only one guy got off of that one. Only one guy got off of that one. So hopefully he'll be quickly dealt with. And then we need to come over here and hope that the two ballistas can reach that. It looks like they can. Are they firing? Yes, they are attacking one of our things here. This isn't good. Leave our granary storage alone. Hang on. Are they out? Have they killed all our people? I suspect... Oh no, one of our guys is still fighting. He's still fighting. And another guy's just come out. So obviously, yeah, they're refreshing their numbers. We need this big guy to die because that thing is almost destroyed. Okay, mass repair everything. Just a bit of wood, that's all. Okay, right. Let's see if we can get away with not getting another villager because that might get us up toward 1,500 food. We need to get there to complete this goal here. When we've done that, we'll see what the next goal is. Because, yeah, we might just be making things a lot harder for ourselves by not ever getting to this goal. Because, obviously, as we play, the waves and waves of baddies are getting slightly tougher. Hang on, what are you? You're a new thing. You're in a red one of these. A red lovely airship. I assume that means it's just harder to sort of knock out the sky. I'm going to assume. Oh, crikey. Okay, right, there we go. So now we need to kill 50 enemies. Now, we've killed quite a lot of enemies. It would have been quite useful had we got to that target earlier. But never mind. So this is going to be one. Where are the others? Ah, there's some coming in here and they brought with them a small moving house. Okay, splendid. Oh my goodness me. Okay, right. We might need some better defense along here. How about then we get ourselves another tower and then now we can spend that money. So we can get this. We'll have a couple of people in that tower and then a barracks probably would not go amiss either. And then can we get at least one more person? Yeah, get one person into there. This is going to be quite tricky to destroy. Yeah, these people are going to run out, thankfully. Oh, it's attacking the tower. It's attacking the tower. Right, in come the people. Choppity chop at the guys underneath. Wonderful. Okay, right. Get another villager. Put somebody else in there. Crikeys. Okay, and there we go. We're 10% of the way through killing our enemies. It doesn't seem enough, does it? And yeah, the south here is really poorly defended. So up there, we've got two barracks and all sorts of bits and bobs. And the south is just not really bothering over that bit. Let's repair everything again. Splendid. Yeah, we need some more down here. We definitely need something else down here. How about another ballista? You can just sit right there. Can we get another person? No. No, we cannot. Hang on. Take somebody out of that, somebody out of that, and put them into there. Okay, Fire. Fire at them. Kill them. Kill them in the face. Oh no, they're going to take down our barracks. Botherations. Okay, right. We might need to get some more people in here. No, we're firing at them quite nicely. There we go. But we did lose our barracks. We can build it back again. That's not a problem. The thing is, manning it up with sort of people is going to be quite tricky. There's one person in there right now. We have killed 16 out of 50 people, though, which is good. Hooray for the slaughter. Okay, what's going to happen next? We need a little bit of time. We need just a tiny bit of time just to build a little bit more sort of a little bit more food up. Another villager down here or two would be great. Do we really need all that metal? Do we need all that metal? Let's drop that down to there. Drop the wood down. That frees up three spaces. So we'll have two in there and another person in there. Okay, wonderful. I'm feeling a little bit safer about that. This bit up here is looking pretty good. Yeah, we could do with another villager though. Right, okay, in comes a villager and we'll put you straight into the barracks. Okay, right, so ballista's firing, people from the barracks all running out to do defending, and I think that lot have been dealt with already. I think we've killed them very much in the face. 26 out of 50. Any others? Nobody else coming right now. Nope. Okay, lovely. Right, can we get, how much is it? 450 food now to train up one villager. And of course, the cost goes up, but then as you get more villagers, they consume more food, so the amount of food you earn comes down. So yeah, as soon as you get a villager, it's a little bit more difficult to get another villager following that. But okay, we'll wait until we get 450 food, and then we'll get another villager, and then we will fully arm. Do you know what we do need to do? We do need to repair that. We can upgrade things. Okay, here's the thing I just learned, everybody. We can upgrade things. Okay. This is fine. Increases durability and damage. 200 of those. Yeah, okay. A level 2 ballista. Let's start leveling up our things. Absolutely. We're not using the sort of wood and steel for anything else. So, yeah, okay. We'll make that a bit better. And what about this? Durability and damage. Yeah, okay. Absolutely, yes. Let's make these things all far superior. So, have we got enough to do that one? Yes. We haven't got enough to improve anything else right now. We'll have to wait a little while for some of the wood to come in. That's fine. Come on, give us 200 and boom. Okay, lovely. So, these have been improved. There are a lot of... Oh, okay. There's stuff going on down here. Possibly should have been aware of that there. I think maybe... Oh, no, here's some more people. The towers are firing. They are causing some good damage. There's a guy with a bomb. Kill the guy with the bomb. Stabbity stab. Okay. Wonderful. Right. What's going on up here? Right. These two things are coming in. Not such a fan of these things. Pop another person into there. And let's see if they can take them down. We can't upgrade this, unfortunately, because we are lacking metal. But it's fine. I think a couple of good shots and we should be able to get that sorted. Another shot. And another one. Boom. Okay. Wonderful. We only need 7 more enemies to be killed. 7 more, and then we can see what the last objective is. So we've done the population one. Now we're on slaughter, and then who knows what the next one is. I do not know. But, oh, hang on a minute. Let's repair everything. Mass repair, please. Thank you very much. Yeah, we need some more food. We could do getting one more villager. One more person, and then... Oh, no, do we need another person? No, maybe we don't need another person. All of our things are sort of fully sort of tooled up to the max there with people. Right, you, hopefully they'll be able to shoot you. That is coming in. Ah, right, there we go. So there is that all there is? Oh no, there's one coming in down here as well. So some foot troops will come that way and some foot troops will come this way. These guys I hope will be dealt with quite quickly. I mean, they've got quite a lot of people running out. There's only 3 of them as well. I think they'll be dead relatively soon. Okay, that was nice and simple. Down here... There are a greater number of people, which is unfortunate. How are we doing on killing the flying things? We don't want that to creep in like it did last time and blow up our longhouse, because that was all very unfortunate. Okay, right. And we've done it. We have taken a glorious victory on that level at the second attempt, because yes, I didn't know that that thing was hovering over our longhouse, throwing explosives on it from the sky. But there we go. So, yeah, sorted. Wonderful. Now, what you do is, when we play, we get research points. Now, when I completed the tutorial level, we got some research points, but I didn't spend any of those. I kind of kept them. So now we've done this level as well. We should have quite a nice pile of research points to spend on stuff to make everything just a little bit better. Oh, this is interesting. So we can either upgrade what we've got or we can buy entirely new things. Oh, this is very exciting. So, in terms of the barracks and the ballista towers, we can expand their range and make them better at causing damage and what have you. Or we can get entirely new towers, and there are only 300 to unlock one of these new towers. So we can get a catapult tower, a frost tower, slows down enemies, lightning tower, shoots bolts of lightning at people, or a shockwave tower, releases high energy shockwaves that momentarily stun enemies. Yeah, I mean, it sounds dramatic, but I'd rather shoot them with lightning, let's be honest. Heavy shock damage to blast enemies with lightning. Yes, please, we'll have a bit of that, thank you very much. And we've still got 2,500 research points left. So how about we increase the damage done by our soldiers from the barracks, because I quite like having troops on the ground. I quite like having the foot troops. And then we will have ourselves, how about we have the ballista towers being better, so more damage. Still got 2,175. Then the lightning tower. How about we just, oh, that's 200 now. So yeah, each time we do a bit of research, it's getting more and more expensive. Let's increase the damage of our lightning towers. Okay. And it's not getting more expensive. I thought they were 30 each or something at one point. Okay, it's gone up to 200. I don't know when that happened. I thought they were much cheaper. Never mind. We've still got 1,975. Let's increase the health of our soldiers so they're going to live a bit longer, which is good. Not so bad about speed, durability. I mean, what's that down there? That's locked. Why can't we get this? That seems like a good thing to have. So we've got the lightning tower. Let's expand the range of the lightning tower. So now that can hit things from further away. So it causes more damage and gets things from further away. Let's do the same to the ballista tower. And then we've got 1,375 left. Do we get ourselves another tower unlocked? Or do we see if unlocking all four of the main sort of upgrades in one tower then unlocks this fancy one at the bottom? Because we won't be able to do both of those things. We could either have ballista towers that are really durable, that are super efficient and might have multi-shot on them that fire three piercing shots, or we could have another type of tower. Do you know what? I like the idea of a catapult tower. Catapult tower deals splash damage, making it the ideal choice for crowd control. Or do we combine the lightning tower with the frost tower, slow people down, and then the lightning tower can just blast them with lightning whilst they're feeling a little bit kind of chilly. How about we do that? Let's use those as a good combo. Let's research that. And now we've got ourselves, we'll do the, yeah, slowing enemy by 30% extra. We'll extend the tower range. And then we've got 675 left. What should we treat ourselves to with this? I mean, soldier speed increase, I'm not so bothered. Durability again. Bolt cost reduced by 50%. Let's get that. Wonderful. And then, I mean, do we just keep the rest? Or do we, let's invest it in that. I don't know. Ah, yeah. So when you get all sort of the upgrades in one sort of tower, you then get access to the fancy upgrade. We don't have the research points for that now. But we've got ourselves some very, very nicely upgraded things now. And a good combo of lightning tower and frost tower. Okay, wonderful. So let's go to the world map. So now, number three. We should be able to have a go at world number three now. Ah, but before we go forth and conquer, hang on a minute, Sky Vikings, wait there. I hadn't really taken into account this panel just here. So we know that there's going to be four objectives on world number three. And the first one of those objectives is going to be kill 20 enemies. That's fine. We can do that. That'll happen by virtue of playing the game. However, there are some level modifiers and we can't remove these. These aren't optional things. We have to abide by these particular rules. And so together, they give us a plus 75% boost the research points that we get from this world, which is quite a lot. That's an awful lot, but they're two quite difficult things to manage, particularly this one here. So dry fields means that our food production is halved. So we're going to have half the food that we would normally have. That's going to be very, very troublesome indeed, because of course we need lots of food to make sure everybody is fed, but also to generate more villagers to go and become soldiers and work the ballistas and work in the towers and work in the fields and all that kind of stuff. So that's going to be really tricky. We're going to need an awful lot of farms. And also our buildings are going to be made of poor timber. So our buildings have 75% of their standard durability. So our buildings are going to be a little tiny bit flimsy. That's not so bad. That's not so bad. This one here is way more worrying. Okay, right. Now that we know that those are things and we're not going to be going in and going, hang on a minute, why are we making no food? Now we know that this is what the story is. Now let's go forth and conquer. Okay, here we go. And right, there are three ways in. to our Longhaus this time round. It's becoming very tricky. Okay, right, so let's get stuff in very quickly. So farms. We want our farms to be really, really optimally placed because they are going to be very, very poor. So, okay, right, put a farm down just there. And yeah, we want three people working in that as soon as possible. Let's get ourselves another villager and another villager and another villager. Let's get lots of villagers. Right, and then we want another farm pretty much immediately. The only thing is it can't have... there's no spot for four tiles around it. But if you put one there, I feel it's a little bit safer. So let's drop a farm in just there as well. So we've got two farms with six people, generating lots of lovely food. So let's train more villagers. Just keep training the villagers. Yeah, so we'll set you two to be default of three people each. That's what we want. We want to be generating lots of food, get another person. Okay, we are going to need some wood. So lumber mill. Can we do a good lumber mill? No, not a perfect one. Do you know what? That one there will do the job. That's quite nice. We'll have one person in there, and then in terms of a quarry or a mine or whatever it is, we'll put you there and we'll have one person in there for now. That leaves three people for some defense. Okay, so the barracks we know about. Ballistas are 200 wood, 125 metal. That's 100, 150. That's 50 and 200. The lightning towers are quite costly indeed. Okay, that's fine. Right, we've got a cap on food. Let's just make sure we get lots of villagers in. Okay, right, where is the first attack going to come in from? In fact, you know what? Whilst nothing much is going on, let's maximise what we've got. While there's no attack happening, let's just get as much of that stuff as we can in. And right, invaders incoming. So from where? Oh my goodness me, there is hardly any room to put anything. There's so little space. There's so little space. Right, where are they coming in from? Over here. Okay, now where does that mean that they're going to attack, though? Are they going to come round the top, or are they going to come round the side? I do not know. Let's find out. Right, they're coming round the side. So let's get ourselves a wonderful lightning tower placed. So get a lightning tower, and then get ourselves a frost tower. And then we can put people in these. Oh, the frost tower doesn't need people in it. Oh, okay. Well, that's quite encouraging. Okay, so we should... That frost tower, it just blows sort of snow on people, and then the lightning tower just sort of zaps them. The lightning tower seems really ineffectual compared to the wonderful ballista. Oh, okay, that's a bit disappointing. Hang on, we'll put that there. We'll generate a thing, and then we'll get somebody to fire bolts at your head. The lightning tower doesn't... Oh, hang on, I've turned it off. Doesn't seem quite as dramatic as I thought it might be. I thought it might be shooting gigantic arcing bolts of light that instantly kill people, but no. That doesn't seem to be the case at all. Okay, that's a bit of a shame. I think we can mass repair. There we go. Okay, right. Get some more people. Get another one and another one. More villagers required. More people. Right, more invaders incoming. Looks like they're coming in from that direction. Any more coming in? No. So just coming in from here. So I guess they're going to come this way. There's a little bit more room up here. There's a little bit of space. How about we put a barracks in here, have that, and just have a classic ballista as well. Can we get another person in? Yes. Okay, right. We'll pop one person in the ballista. And the ballistas are going to be more dangerous because we upgraded them, as are our soldiers. So they're going to be tougher, they've got more health, and they're going to cause more damage. Okay, wonderful. Right, fire at them, fire at fire, and that's that wave dealt with. Quick check just to make sure that nobody else has crept in without us knowing. Okay. Right, we're maxing out on metal, so let's drop you. Let's save ourselves a person right now. We'll get another villager. And if they attack from this side, if they attack from over here, our options are quite limited. And we might want to increase our sort of maximum storage by building these things, by building the granaries and what have you. But we haven't really got any room for that around the longhouse. The longhouse is just surrounded by stuff. We could get another farm. We could get another farm. Let's pop another farm down. We'll put two people in it right now, and then we can always rejig that. We can always sort of move things around. So, get another villager, get another villager. So we've got two villagers standing by, and... Okay, right. Oh no. Oh no, we haven't got any room for shooty things. Hang on. Defense, and ballista tower, and one right there, and put two people in it. That should hopefully be able to shoot at the thing in the sky. Please shoot at the thing in the sky, not the birds. The birds are fine. You can leave the birds. They're okay. We like the birds. Shoot that thing, though. There we go. Wonderful. And I wouldn't mind getting a barracks in over this side as well, although there is nobody to go in it right now. Okay. A bit more food, please. We need, what do we need? 270. It's actually coming in quite nicely. There we go. We'll put two people in that barracks just there. I will admit, I'm a bit disappointed with the lightning tower. I'm a bit disappointed. I thought that would just be really kind of crazy, sort of, you know, killing people from really far away, but it's got a really short distance. And the, I suppose, yeah, the frost tower's quite good. Quite like the frost tower. It just blows sort of cold on people. Okay, hang on. 280 to get another person. Where are they coming in from? Where are the baddies coming in from? This side. So they're going to come in from over here. That's mass repair stuff. Okay. Do we get another person? Yes, please. And then we'll put them in the ballista. The ballista seem to be our most sort of, our most trustworthy of defences. I'm not entirely swayed by the lightning thing and the cold thing. I'm not feeling them quite so much. And then we need to look somewhere at where we can put some of these things. We need a bit of extra storage. And there's a little bit over here. We could put a granary just there. We could put a lumber pile just there. And we could put a metal storage just there. So they just sort of all crammed into this bit. Because there's a bit of room up here. We can still fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more defensive things in here. And defend this sort of way into the longhouse. Over here, only 2 things. Over here, 2 or 3 things possibly. Okay, right, go back to defence. What else can we get then? So we do need some more people. So I think we can train 2 more people now. Wonderful. Okay, excellent. 2 more people training up. Very good. Let's put 1 of you in there, back into the farm, to generate some more food so we can get more people in a bit quicker. What do we need next? 310. 310. Right. Invaders incoming. From which direction, please, game? Okay, from over here. Is that it? Quick sweep around. It's so pretty when you zoom out. I do like that. I like our kind of flying, floating Sky Viking island. I mean, I like it less that it's being attacked by these kind of troublemaking nuisances over here, but it looks great. Okay, get ourselves another person. We will have another person in the barracks, and that ballista is completely full. Okay, so where next needs a bit of help? Down here, I would say. And then, can we get a barracks in as well? That would be good. So let's pop a barracks in just there, and we'll get ourselves another villager trained up. We will pop somebody into there. Okay, so that side's looking okay. That side looks okay. Do we need to do a bit of repairing? A tiny bit of repairing. So that's not so bad. I'm okay with that. Yeah, it's sort of, this side is a bit weak, and that side's not very good either. How many do we need for another villager? 330. How about we save it until the next attack rolls round? When we know where they're attacking from, we can then invest in as many villagers as we can afford. And that means that we're not going to sacrifice that kind of plus 11 bonus right now. If we just bought a villager right now and sat there in that barracks, they're going to be eating the food. So our food is going to be going up a little bit slower. So let's wait. Let's wait until the enemy attack. We're going to need at least 660, probably 670 or 680 food. But it does look like we can get ourselves 2 extra villagers. Okay, they're coming in from over there. Is that it? Yes, it is. Right, they're kindly just coming in from the same direction. Okay, lovely. 2 people, 1 in there, and 1 soldier, because we've upgraded the barracks. So our soldiers are pretty tough now. Okay, I'm happy with that. Can we get ourselves a lightning tower over this side? Just because it's a fun thing? Yeah, let's pop a lightning tower in. And we need 350 food to actually equip this. Oh no, quick. Quick, quick, quick. I know the lightning tower hasn't got anybody in it. It'll have somebody in it momentarily if we just wait a second. Right, drop somebody into the lightning tower. Jibbity jabbity with lightning, please. And boom, dead. And then kill the baddies. They're being shot with lightning and being stabbed by people. They're being shot with lightning and they're also being fired at by a ballista. Happy days. Okay, objective complete. Hooray. Okay, have a total of 40 villagers. Okay, we're working toward that. I rather suspect that we will run out of food before we get to that point. We're going to need another farm in. That's okay. That's not the best farm position, is it? I mean, there's quite... That's a perfect spot for a farm, but it is a little bit isolated. Yeah, it's going to be quite hard to defend. I think we might have to go for there for now. Let's just drop that in. That's fine. And then we'll get some villagers in. And then we'll defend. That'll be fine. Yeah, I'm not feeling this here. Can we knock buildings down? If we needed to destroy this, destroy building. Okay, yeah, we can. just in case we need to. Okay, how's it go? How's the fighting going? Can we do a mass repair? Couldn't repair everything. Oh, okay, why not? Why can't we repair everything? Oh, is it because there's stuff coming in? Is it because there is stuff coming in? Okay. Okay, this is bad. This is bad. Okay, right. We're going to have to destroy the lumber mill. I'm really sorry, chaps. Sorry. My apologies. Defense, ballista, put that in. Get as many people as you can afford. Chuck them all in. Throw everybody in and fire at those things. Run out. Do you know what? Let's upgrade that thing as well to make it a bit more dangerous. Boom and boom. Okay, right. So now we don't have anybody gathering wood. We do not have any sort of wood source. Okay, right. Hang on a second. Hang on. Production, a lumber mill. Yeah. When you put it down, it creates a space. That's interesting. That is interesting. We could put another thing down and create another space over there. That gets four tiles around it. Let's do that. And then we need some more villagers. Right, one villager for now. Pop you into there. Okay. Ah, they're coming in on this side. Let's improve that. Can we get another villager? 390. Not quite yet, but they will take damage from a lightning tower. We are going to shoot them with lightning, which is all very exciting. Right, you guys should spring into life, I imagine. Yep, splendid. And we can get a person. Get another person in to go and stabbity-stabbity these guys. I think our guy's doing a pretty good job, and he's been helped out by the obviously ballista tower and everything else. Okay, right, repair. All repairs done. Marvellous. Oh, hang on. Over here, looks like our people are being mercilessly chopped apart. Okay, wonderful. There we go. I kind of forgot to look over there. Never mind. Okay, how are we looking for food? We need another... Oh, we need 400 food to get another villager in. Yeah, it's expensive now. It's expensive to get the villagers in. And more raiders are incoming. However, it looks like they're all coming in from this side. Unless that's a floaty sort of bomb thing. No, that's fine. Okay, another villager, please. And we'll put them into the... Let's put them into the ballista tower. Can we upgrade this while we're here? Durability and damage. Yeah, we'll have a bit of that. And then can we make that better as well? So that ballista tower is a level 2 ballista tower, so it should cause a bit more damage. Oh, there's three big lads over here. Oh, botherations. Okay. Okay. Yeah, this is where we need the great big catapulty thing that we didn't take. Because that would have caused that loads of damage. Hang on, right. Couldn't repair everything. Yeah. Okay, hang on a second. Get another person in. Yeah, now that is that going to regenerate? Oh no, we're going to lose our expensive lightning tower. Get the person out of there. Get the person out. I think, did we just about save that? All repairs done. Nowhere else seems to be on fire. Although, you know, it's raining, so that might have helped a bit. Okay. Okay, fine. Everyone's still alive. Pop somebody back into the lightning tower. My goodness me. Right, can we upgrade that? Level 2 ballista tower. Splendid. So that's level 2. And then we need 400 wood to elevate it up to the next level. Crikeys. Okay, what's that coming in? Something coming in from there. And something coming in from this side. This side's actually pretty well defended. I'm okay with this bit. Over here, this side is very, very flimsy looking right now. How about then? Right, what's happened there? There are three people with big explodey things. That's probably really bad. And here, we've got ourselves guys under a kind of, you know, sort of little covered wagon thing. But the covered wagon has been destroyed by our people who just ran in and did a pretty good job. Well done, everybody. Well done, that's very impressive. Oh yeah, there were some guys up here, weren't there? Oh, okay, that's been dealt with as well. Yay, well done, everybody. Kind of forgot about the guys with the bombs up there. Okay, what do we need? Ah, get another villager. 430 money. 440 food now to get the next villager. We do have a spare villager, though. Is anyone in need of support? Maybe put somebody into there for now? And just see what happens, see where the attack's coming from. We could put down a few more of these frost towers. They could be quite handy. I think I've got a good place for those. Unless, can we put it on there? Can we put it on that rock? We can't put it on the edge. Oh, I think we can just override. Okay, right, you can build on things. I hadn't kind of taken that into account. I didn't think you could build on them. Okay, it turns out you can build wherever you like. Okay. Well, that makes things a bit easier, doesn't it? Yeah, we can just put it there. Okay, well, there you go. That's an important lesson I've just learned right at the end there. Okay, that's fine. Right, they're all coming through on... These guys are going to come down here. I imagine. Hang on, we'll complete this. 2,500 of each resource. Right, they're being frozen. They are being hit with lightning. These guys over here are having an unpleasant time of it, which is good because they are trying to come and, you know, kill us. And then over here... This should go down pretty easily, I would have thought. What are we still... Are we still shooting at something? Right. That thing in there, then. Yeah, that thing in there probably worth shooting at. Better shoot that. Right, so in come our... So foot soldiers. Run under there and stab the guys in their little moving house to death. And that is all sorted. Splendid. 2,500 of each resource. We're going to need a lot of these things scattered around the place. Okay. Let's try and work on it then. So metal storage. Where can we put metal storage? Now, yeah, now we know that we can build on things, however. That makes life a bit easier. So, I mean, yeah, we could just put things just here. We're not going to use any of those squares there. So, I mean, yeah, I didn't think we could build on things. Okay, right. Life is slightly more straightforward now. How embarrassing. Okay, never mind. Right. So, put things in here. So, there we go. Right. So, loading up there so we can have 2,000 food. So we need another granary somewhere, which I suppose could live there, because we're not going to put anything over here. Hang on. There's baddies. Possibly should concentrate on the baddies. Oh, they're in sinister. They are in sinister doom looking ships now. Okay. Right. And here comes some. Oh, crikey. There's loads of them. There's absolutely loads of them coming in. Okay. Right. Two lots of people. Right. Equip somebody into there. And yeah, there's a lot of people over here. There's a lot of people coming in. Hang on a minute. Let's get another ballista in. Let's at least put somebody into that. Crikeys. Okay, right. They're being frozen, which is good. So they're cooling down. Our guys are coming in to try and chop them. Well done, chaps. That big guy is a bit of a problem. Oh no. He blew up our frost tower thing. How rude. Let's put it straight back. There we go. Frost tower back in. Okay, right. Repair things. Nothing to repair. Okay. Things are looking fine. How long till we get another person? 470 before we can get another person. And we still need some more storages. Okay. What tiles are we not going to use? We're unlikely to use any of those tiles there. So let's put a wood storage thing just there. That doesn't affect our farms. And then another wood storage thing just there. And then we can't build any more of these now. We need some more wood. Okay, fine. We'll have to wait for that to slowly kind of trickle in. We could build the granary. We could get the granary in right now. Let's do that. So we can have maximum granary. We can have maximum wood. We cannot yet have maximum metal. We need about 400 wood for that. Okay, that's going to be a bit of a problem. Okay, train a villager. Let's pop somebody into the lumber mill to try and speed that up a tiny bit. Because obviously the longer we leave it, the harder it's going to be, because they are sending in waves and waves of very, very big, scary people now. Okay, up here, looks like they're taking care of that quite nicely. Down here, no attack. Over here, great big attack going on with snow, kind of ice pouring in to slow down the enemy. This is good though. It's us four against one of the giant, big, kind of tough looking guys. And he's dead, splendid. And there's one of them. Can we kill that, please? Can we kill this really soon? It would be nice if we could kill this slightly more urgently. Yeah, and I see, now I know that you can put things down on anything. It's so easy to defend this place. I thought that the tiles with the resources on were sort of reserved tiles and we could not build anything on them. Well, there you go. There you go. You live and learn. Right, 480. We'll have another villager. So we've got a spare villager. At the moment, drop you into there, because this side is a little bit less defended than the others. That is also in a really silly place now. That's in a very silly place. Can we demolish that? Destroy that, please. So blow that up. It's not in a good place. And the frost tower could go... Now we know we can put it on rocks and things. Can we put it there? It seems to work quite well there. Right, and production. Can we get another metal storage? Pop that there. That's not going to ruin anything to do with our sort of metal gathering. And then another metal storage. Where can we put this, which is not going to affect anything? Over there, that'll do. Okay, so now we should be able to, in theory, store 2,500 units of everything. We just need to actually do that. Lots of people down here causing us a bit of a problem. Quick, killity kill. There's a big lad. There's a big guy there. He's not got a helmet on, but he has got a great big kind of axe thing. Anywhere else having a bit of a problem? Over here. Ah, they're attacking our foot soldiers. Splendid. Right, kill those guys in their little sort of moving house thingamajig. And, okay, repair everything. Repairs done. Can we get another villager? Yes, we can. Okay, so now it's becoming incredibly expensive. And it's going up very, very slowly to get the villagers. Okay, fine. 2,500 of each resource. We now just need to let that just tick up. We just need to sort of hold on. The wood is going to be a problem, isn't it? We're quite low on the wood. And the food is going up very slowly as well. Okay, right. We just need to survive now. Now the goal is just to stay alive until those things top up, which could take a heck of a long time, particularly with the food. Those guys are going to be no trouble at all. Who else is attacking? Down here, they should be okay. The lightning thing is doing a pretty good job. We do need the support of the foot troops coming in and just doing some killity killing. Okay, wonderful. And then over this side, they are being killed. And there we go. Okay. So one attack down, 14 invasions we've done so far. And we're, what, about a fifth of the way there for food. We might need to just put another farm down somewhere. We've got one person that can work it, but plus five is just too slow. Plus five is really slow. And if we put a farm just there, the thing is the enemy are going to come in and just destroy that. But that's fine for now. It's only 70 wood, and the wood is going up okay. So how about we go... put a farm there, and then the metal, we can take somebody out. We've only got this one metal mine, so take that out, and then, yeah, make sure there's three people in that farm. Going up by plus 12. Okay, that's good. And then we'll have another person in the lumber mill to increase the amount of wood we're gathering. So that will slowly tick up, and then we can just sort of manage the numbers. We can just move things around. Okay, right. Two sort of bombship things coming in, and three bombship things coming. Oh my goodness me, everything is coming in. All of the things are happening all at the same time. Right, you lot, kill that thing there. That will be not long for this world. They will easily take that out. And beautiful, gone. Right, somebody needs to shoot that. Over here, dealt with. This side, that looks like it's been dealt with as well. The farm is still there, looking nice, which is good. And, right, hang on, do some repairs. I know it costs us some materials, but we need to keep everything running. So let's repair stuff. Food ticking up, wood ticking up, metal ticking up slightly slower than would be nice, but at least it's moving. And finish this thing off. Take your time with it, though. There you go. Crikeys. Okay. What's after this, though? What's going to be after this? This isn't even our final goal. So, right. Okay, fine. So let's just see these things slowly ticking up to 2,500. Okay, so we've just survived another wave. Our wood is looking very good. So let's move the wood down to 1, and then let's go back to the mine and put that back up to 3. So by the time that that goes to 2,500, that should also be ticking up quite nicely. So, right, there is another invasion on the way, and they're getting quite tricky now. There's an awful lot of them. Yeah, there's loads. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... six ships coming in. Okay. Ah, and this could be a problem. We might lose this farm just here. We might lose this farm. Okay, get everybody out. Get the people out. Bring them back in, because yeah, that's just going to get destroyed. But we knew that was the case. That was just there just to get some stuff, just to get some food very, very quickly indeed. Right, in come a lot of our guys to choppity chop those baddies up. Okay, wonderful. That's dealt with. Over here is looking like there's a bit of a scrap going on. Oh, and we've got the victory. Okay, there we go. Right, so we must have, I don't know what the fourth objective was. Okay, I don't know. I'm not entirely sure if we can see what they were, but there we go. We have achieved victory on that level as well, which is wonderful. And of course, yeah, we get our great big load of sort of research points and what have you. So yeah, 2,625 research points. So we shall finish up with Longhaus for now. I think we've seen enough of it to get a good picture of what the game's all about and how it works and all that kind of stuff. But I am amazed that this is a free game. I am flabbergasted. My flabber is well and truly gasted that this game is free, because it's so professional and it's so well put together. I would never think that it's free. I mean, when we were playing, we had no bugs, we had no glitches, the game was really well balanced, it looked amazing, it played really well. It's just a really kind of polished game. I mean, even the menu that we're looking at here, Even this menu looks really, really professional. It does not look like the menu of a game that you can get for free. So I'm very, very impressed. So I'm really glad we played Longhaus. If you want to have a go as well, of course, there is a link to the itch.io page in the video description below where you can go and have a little go yourself and you can become your own tribe of Sky Vikings and see how you get on. But we shall indeed finish up for now. Hopefully you did enjoy this. If you did, then please do leave a like. That would be most marvellous indeed. And also, if you're not already, then please do subscribe to keep up to date with all the other stuff that we get up to in the Geek Cupboard. But for now, thank you very much for joining me in the Geek Cupboard and I will see you next time. Cunic, your time is now, and you have missed, Cunic. This is unacceptable, Cunic. An Ash's caravan has been ambushed by man-hunting chinchillas. Are you going to land on my potatoes? That is just not the done thing. Oh, there's a lot of them. One, two, three. These guys have got amazing hair. I'm delighted that we've actually done something, and it's worked.